Track and Field Weekly Update with Head Coach Rod DeHaven. A successful weekend for your program, the Jim Emmerich. Kyle Burdick won the 3,000. Sam Zenner had a good weekend. Rachel King took second in the 3,000 as well. Just a lot of athletes making some marks.
Yeah, I think it was a weekend where we took another step forward for our student athletes in our program. Coupled with the meet on Friday with the Division II Invitational, where we actually had a couple school records there, Oksana Covey in the 600 meters. And, you know, for Oksana last year, you know, having to sit out both the entire 2018 campaign, she's made a fairly quick recovery and getting back into, you know, full race mode. And then Kyle, really dominated performance in the 1,000 meters. And then moving to Saturday, you know, having you know, a couple conference rivals in here, I think our student athletes stepped up in a large way. You know, Rachel King did win the mile in a very tight, close race. And you know, I think 3K probably didn't go as well as she wanted, but some of that was breaking off the rust, you know, from a break from the cross country season. And Sam Zenner, of course, had an amazing day to put down, you know, two school records, and particularly the mark in the 200 was jaw-dropping, to say the least. You know, it also was the fastest collegiate mark by a collegiate athlete in South Dakota by nearly 0.4 of a second, and you know, ranks in the top 10 nationally, and just, you know, really, really impressive improvement for him over last year. And I think, you know, he was obviously disappointed how last season went, and he did some things to allow himself to get better. In the throws, Logan Almond, you know, had another PR, you know, 2 weeks in a row. So good to see that. I know Noah Huber's on the verge of something big in the shot put. Abby Sudbeck in the weight throw, I think, is, you know, returning to form after an injury this fall. You know, the jumps, you know, some young people there in the women's high jump, you know, had some nice marks. Addison Eisenbeis, you know, going over 5.6. And then Bryant Quarter, you know, starting to get back into his groove as well in those events. Nick Wessels in the hurdles. And we had a lot of event winners, so I'm sure I'm going to miss somebody. But, you know, it was, I think we really performed well at home. And that's what you hope, that you take advantage of not having to be on the road and, you know, getting up early and getting on a bus and you know, negotiating all that. So it was good. However, we cannot rest on our laurels. Nobody else in the conference will, and you know, we need to pick it up. And you know, if we want athletes to, you know, to move on and be, you know, potentially the NCAAs, everybody's going to have to, you know, raise the bar. And you know, again, this is a big season for us, having the conference meet at home. And you know, really happy with the progress, but certainly in the next, again, next every week kind of, you know, tells a new story, and we need to continue to train hard and be focused on the task at hand.
Looking ahead, it sounds like you got a number of athletes going to multiple places this weekend.
Yeah, the squad will split up a little bit this weekend to try and maximize opportunities in terms of competition or venue. We'll send our multi-event athletes up to the University of North Dakota for a meetup there. And then a large portion of the team will also kind of follow them on Saturday. We'll have a few athletes over at the University of Minnesota, and then a few athletes at Pitt State to try and take advantage of their particular facility in terms of the jumps. So, you know, again, an opportunity hopefully for us to get better and, you know, kind of see how we perform when we're back out on the road. And then a couple of weeks from now, of course, we'll be back home for the SDSU Classic and really won't have to leave Brookings until the outdoor season. Again, it's, you know, it's a part of the season where the athletes need to train pretty hard and then, you know, still manage to try and perform well, maybe with some tired legs or tired arms or whatever the case might be.